So you just got your first Chromebook. Now what? The first thing we're going to do is turn it on. For some Chromebooks, as soon as you lift the lid of the computer, they will turn on. For others, you'll need to press the power button. The power button is located at the top right-hand corner of the keyboard. After your Chromebook is on, you're going to want to log in. The great thing about Chromebooks is that anyone who picks up a Chromebook can log in with their Google Apps account and use the device. You can see here three users have already used this Chromebook. If, however, you are new to the device and you don't yet have a profile, what you're going to want to do is log in and create a new person. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Add Person. After that point, you will see the Google login screen, and all you will need to do is put your httpsnc.org email and the password and click Sign In. We talked a little bit about the power button on the top right, but let's go through some of the keys that are actually different on a Chromebook. You're used to the escape key, but next to the escape key is a left arrow button and a right arrow button. These are used when you're on a website and you want to go backward or forward. The other neat key is the refresh key. Often it's hard to find in a browser where to refresh the page, so you get a new version of the page. Simply tap that key and you'll get a refreshed version of the page. This key is called the immersive mode key, and what that does is it gets rid of all the menus and simply shows you the page as it is without any of the tabs or the launcher. Overview mode, which is the square key with the two lines, this shows all the windows that you have open at that time. This is a great way to switch between apps. Next to the overview mode key, we have the key that dims the screen and the key that brightens the screen. Beside that, you have your mute button, your decrease volume button, and your increase volume button. And then there's that power button once again. The other button that you may find different is instead of a caps lock key, you have a search key. This search allows you to search your apps and the internet all at the same time. For caps lock, you're going to press Alt and search, then you're going to get a caps lock key. Above the screen of your Chromebook, you'll also see that you have a webcam and some built-in microphones. You will also notice that you have a place to put headphones, a USB port, and instead of a VGA, you will have what's called an HDMI. This is so that you get better quality images when you connect items. If you have a projector, you will not be able to connect it from VGA. This is a VGA cable. This will not fit here. So what you need to do is you need to buy something that's called an adapter or converter that has an HDMI port on one end and has the VGA connector on the other. That way, you can plug in HDMI and then add your projector into the converter box. You'll notice right away that your Chromebook is a little different than a laptop, in that software is not installed on your Chromebook. As you saw in the video before, this is a cloud device. However, that doesn't mean that you can't do anything on this device. There are plenty of apps available for you to use. To find which apps you have available, you'll click in the lower left-hand corner on the magnifying glass or the launcher. This will bring up a Google search window where you could begin a search that would directly search the web. It also gives you access to all your files in Google. And there's a button called All Apps that lets you see all the apps you have available to you. So at any time, you can open any of these apps. It's sort of like a cross between having a device like an iPad with individual apps, but having it more in a laptop-like environment. The other area of the Chromebook you'll want to be familiar with is your status area. Down in the status area, you'll notice a small picture of yourself that you can click on at any time. This is where you get to other ways to connect to other networks in case you take it off the HCPS network. It gives you options to enable Bluetooth. And it also gives you an area to sign out. If you're the only one using this device, you won't need to sign out. When you're finished, you'll just shut down. The shutdown button is the one that looks like the power button. To the right of that, you'll see the lock button. What this does is it immediately brings in the login screen. It doesn't shut the device down, but if you have to step away from your Chromebook and help students, you can click the lock button. You'll see that they'll have to enter their password, and then the device is available again. Also in the status area, you'll see your percentage of battery. One of the things you'll find out quickly is a Chromebook battery lasts a very long time. You'll also see settings. This is an area where you can go to make certain changes to your Chromebook. For example, the wallpaper, or change the sensitivity of your touchpad. So make yourself familiar with the settings area. There's also some little quick links here where you can see your wireless status and your battery status without clicking on the actual picture of you, but that is where you're going to get to the main areas. This has also got volume control, so a lot of your controls can be found there. What you saw at the beginning of this video is how quickly a Chromebook starts up. It just as quickly shuts down. So there's no waiting, which is going to be a welcome change from the length of time it takes to start up or shut down a laptop. Battery life will last anywhere from 6.5 to 10 hours. This device is easily shared with Google users. Simply log off, hand your device to someone else, and when they log in, they'll only have access to what they have stored in their Google Apps account. There's no concern over sharing documents on a device or having a user access your documents when they are not supposed to. This device only brings down what that particular Google Apps user has access to. A couple of other things you want to make sure that you know is that SMARTBoards can't be used with Chromebooks. Some other peripherals can be used. Those are just going to have to be trial and error. There's built-in virus protection, and apps are always updated on their own. So you don't have to worry about updating your apps like you do on an iPad or your iPhone. Chrome will do it for you. Every time you turn on your Chromebook, you will have the newest version of the Chrome OS and the newest version of your apps. Now, we're going to take a look at a very important setting that you're going to want to change just in case you ever lose internet access while having your device. To do this, we're going to go to Drive, and we can get there by going to the search button, going to all apps, and finding Google Drive. Now, just as an aside, if you would like to add this Google Drive shortcut to the bottom of your screen, you can simply drag and drop it to pin it at the bottom. Open up your Google Drive, and what you're going to want to do as soon as your Google Drive loads is you're going to want to go to the gear. So I'm going to go up to the gear, and I'm going to go to settings. Once your settings load, what we are looking for is a way to be able to use your device offline in the event that you had no internet access. To do that, you're going to make sure that next to offline, you have a check mark in the Sync Google Docs Sheet Slides and Drawings section so that you can make sure that you can continue to work if you lose internet access. After you make sure this check mark is placed, please make sure that you click Save or Done. Thanks for joining us. For more information about Chromebooks, go to our website and follow the directions on the screen above. Thanks.